Hello, this is Movie Geek, and today I'm talking Star Trek Discovery. Discovery is the most recent incarnation of the Everlasting series created by Gene Roddenberry. The first two episodes were uploaded to Netflix, and I've just got to say, they're not as bad as I had expected. Just before release, there was an embargo on reviews, which usually means that it's a bad thing, and they don't want the reviews to come out. Producers and the directors probably don't have faith in the product. But after watching the first two episodes, I can say it was basically a good setup to a new Star Trek series. I'm not saying it was perfect, it was far from it, but it feels new and fresh for the 51-year-old franchise. It sets up the premise, it gives us the main characters, and unfortunately, due to the build-up in marketing, we know who is extendable and who... I remember when Enterprise came out back in 2001. And how it disappointed me. How the prequel to the original series seemed more in line with the post-TNG series. There was not the link to the original series that had been promised. There wasn't the fun from the original series that it was known for until the final season of Enterprise. Now with Star Trek Discovery, we have yet another prequel. Set closer to the original series, I think it's about 10 years, and back within the original timeline. Again, unfortunately, it seems more in line with the more recent Kelvin-verse Star Trek than the 60s camp and colourful feel of the original. In my opinion, Star Trek has lost something between the 60s and the early 90s, when the colour and fun began leaving the franchise. Instead of distancing itself from Star Trek like Enterprise did, especially with its folksy theme song, it gives us a new theme opening with the signature trumpet call that has accompanied the majority of the different series. But as with all series now, there is an undertone of seriousness. Maybe something from reality is creeping in. But that is okay, I suppose. The original series was full of relevant commentary from the 60s, having a multicultural cast and characters. Throwing off all the shackles that were weighing down the world at the time. There were so many good episodes, strangely still relevant today. Oddly, despite making the connection to the original series, I feel it's more in line with the Kelvinverse and more likely the way our technology is today. Star Trek is a series based in fact. Science from the time predicted things that exist today. Communicators, mobile phones are the main example. But there is like ongoing work on hospital beds that can read a person's vitals. But times have changed since the 60s and we've progressed technologically. So Discovery's technology appears to be a lot more advanced than it would within the original series. Looks more in line with the 2009 Star Trek film. The story is simple, starting with an away mission to help a pre-warp civilization survive by fixing their water supply. We get to meet the crew, a nice mix of races, human and alien, and an interesting take on the human-Vulcan interplay, with the main character, Michael Burnham, being a human who has grown up on Vulcan. We have the original series alum in the recast Sarek, Spock's father, being the adopted father of Burnham. But the story is a simple one, investigating the destruction of an array on the edge of the Federation space. They encounter a Klingon beacon, cloaked from view. We get a callback to Star Trek The Motion Picture as Burnham takes a spacesuit and traverses space to reach the beacon, akin to Spock communicating with Bija. Then it's a standoff between Klingon Federation, and the simple premise is enough to start off a brand new branch of the time, of the franchise. Story is good, it works, it's entertaining. We see the setup of the new Klingon Empire and the mistakes the Federation make that ignite the fire under the leaderless Klingons. It has a Cold War feel to it, with the ships not budging from, but holding strong opposite each other, each waiting for the other one to begin fighting. I found as well though, was the Klingons have a point. The threat is the indoctrination and loss of individual culture that the Federation posed towards the Klingons. Them, the Federation is an imposing empire ready to assimilate the individual cultures of the galaxy into one neat, colourless uniform. The Klingons attempt to strike before the threat is too much, and I suspect this will play heavily in the upcoming series. This arc storytelling is a slight bone of contention with me, because the last time they tried it, it was the Dire Zindi plot from Enterprise. When they ended that season-long arc, they brought in the double and triple episode stories that unfortunately was a little bit too late for the series, and yet gave us some of the best episodes. I just hope they intersperse the series with some standalone episodes, give us entertaining Star Trek rather than a massive story that will become repetitive and boring. Give us Star Trek. But if we look at Netflix's most recent exports, the Marvel stuff, House of Cards, they benefit from small episode count and sharp direct writing. So hopefully we will get classic Star Trek within these episodes. Overall, the two pilot episodes were entertaining. They looked good and sounded great. The sound effects were original series, as they could get. The ping on the bridge, the shh at the doors, the transporter and communicator sounds. Their Enterprise tried to distance itself from the original series and link itself to the Brannon, Braga, Rick Berman version of Star Trek, with the costume and the ship design and the stilted delivery of lines. Discovery appears to be mixing the two, giving a bridge between the two shows. It is supposed to be set 10 years before the original series, and I would like to see them shift into costume design and colour palette from the original series. I've been a Movie Geek, and I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching.